important word at the Big Four parks, because that's who they cater for.
The kids. You've seen the kids here this morning riding their push bikes around in peace and quiet in these streets. You cannot do that in a motel.
Tony Simmons runs Big Four's Dubbo Parklands, and it's one of the busiest in Australia.
As you've seen, a lot have gone out today, but a whole lot more will come back in tonight.
Well, so this will fill up again tonight?
We were full last night, and we'll be full again tonight.
So they're all using the holiday guide?
They certainly are. They go from one Big Four to the next Big Four. There's 170 Big Four holiday parks around the country, and that just tells them where to go next. So they leave our Big Four and they go to the next Big Four up the road.
You don't call them caravan parks?
No, it's a holiday park. They come here for a holiday.
They holiday in tents, they holiday in vans, they holiday in the cabins, but they all come here for the same thing. And it's not just the table tennis. Or the heated pool. Tell them, Tone.
It's a halfway point for people travelling north and south, but also there's a week. You can spend a week in Dubbo. There's so many things you can do here with zoos and jails and golf courses and wineries and things of that nature.
Just a 7-iron across the road, there's 27 holes for those who play.
It's like the holiday park. It's got a big backyard.
It's a great backyard, but I tell you what, Coxie, careful of the slice on this hole. You could end up in the zoo.
Yeah, all right.
I think you could be in trouble.
The Macquarie cabins are the top of the range, with features you don't necessarily get in other places.
You've even gone to the gold numbers, like...
Gold numbers, Hostar. Plasma TVs, great balcony to sit on and have a glass of wine.
Whatever happened to roughing it when you go on holiday? Well, it's gone out the door,
it's gone
is it?
Out the... People don't do that anymore. They like to live in comfort.
Today, Tony has put together a barbecue and wine tasting fundraiser for the Clown Doctors, the Big Four's chosen charity.
It's all part of the holiday park experience. People are on the road, they come, they want to get together at a great little venue like this, they make friends at places. This is how they meet people on the road, just a fantastic experience.
The whole facilities here, like the barbecue area, everything's like first class.
First rate, you won't get better. It's fantastic and everyone's having a good time, you can see that. So.
Cheers. I think you did better than I did.
Judy and Ron have just joined the caravan brigade.
Yeah, but you could have bought a holiday house. Why'd you buy a caravan?
Yeah, but if you buy a holiday house, you've got to buy a lawnmower, then you've got to buy a hose and everything, and then cut the lawn, haven't you? This way you let somebody else cut the lawn and we'll just keep moving on.
Well, I'm going to keep moving on too. The zoo's just down the road. In fact, it's an easy 2K pedal. And keeper Hayley Joseph introduces me to the tallest resident of them all.
You sure this is going to work?
Yep. Just let them take it.
Go on. Hello.
Kiss. Mwah, thank you.
Here we go, one of those. There we go. Tell me about the encounters.
Just like you're doing now, we've got the giraffe in focus where people have the opportunity to come up nice and close with these guys, one-on-one sort of photo opportunity, and obviously feed them their favourite food.
Do you want one? No. No, but you think of fellas, it's about the length of the tongues. What about you? Would you
these like giraffes one? Are so friendly, and it's pretty obvious they share a good relationship with Hayley.
They're amazing, aren't they? They're beautiful.